a glass of wine a day keeps the doctor away. Nope, I don't care what the scientists say, I'm just gonna keep on drinking. Hey everyone, Lacey Green here for DNews. Red wine, it's got superpowers, right? It can fight cancer, inflammation, heart disease. This is thought to be because of two key components in the wine. One, the antioxidants, and two, the ethanol alcohol itself. Red wine does have some antioxidants in it, in particular, an antioxidant called resveratrol, which is also found in dark chocolate. Resveratrol has been widely tested in lab animals, and scientists found that it improved animals' heart function, ability to use insulin, and that it may also provide some protective effects against diabetes and obesity. In humans, however, the benefits hadn't been tested until now. A new study published in JAMA Internal Medicine monitored the substance's metabolites in the urine of almost 800 Italians over the course of 9 years. They found that more resveratrol didn't actually translate into lower rates of cancer, heart disease, or risk of death. Womp, womp. So the conclusion is that it probably isn't the antioxidants doing the trick. The lead researcher at Harvard said that the reason the benefits may have been seen in lab animals and not humans is that the amount that you have to consume is way, way more. A human would have to drink 1,000 liters of red wine every day, which will give you a nice little trip to your grave. Fun fact, the resveratrol health craze has created a $30 million industry selling supplements. There's no data on how well they work, but the scientists have noted that, like most supplements, your body probably doesn't absorb them in supplement form, which means you're better off eating lots of greens, beans, and berries than drinking a glass of wine or taking a supplement. So this research doesn't mean that wine isn't a heart-healthy option. There are still many studies that demonstrate wine's ability to raise good cholesterol, lower bad cholesterol, and protect the arteries from damage. What we're learning is that it may just be the case that antioxidants aren't the reason why the wine helps. It could be because of a different polyphenolic antioxidant in the wine, or maybe from the ethanol. There's already been some research suggesting that it's small amounts of alcohol that could be doing the trick, in which case it's not necessarily red wine that can provide the protective benefits. It could be any kind of alcohol. And maybe we see the effect with wine drinkers particularly because the serving size is small enough. We'll keep you updated if we see any more studies about alcohol and your heart health. Thanks for joining me for DNews. I'll see you next time.